Our fourth question is about to categorize some points in two groups. One group is G1 and other group is G2. So it is saying that there are some points A, B, C, D, E, F. 5 points are given and 2 points are labeled as G1 and G2. So based on this logic, we have to find where the C, D, E, F will lie, either in G1 or in G2. For that purpose, Anita has found a way. So what does it mean? This is a point A. A is 1, 0.5, let's say here. B is 5, 0.5, means here somewhere. If I say x and y, 4, 0.2, means here, and D is 4, 0.8, here. E is 3.8, so 3 and 0.8 will be here, and F is 7, 0.8, which will be here somewhere. Now we need to categorize in which group it lies. So what she has done, she has found a function, and based on that she categorized in G1 and G2. So A is G1, which means this is G1, and B is G2. G2, B was 5, so this was G2. How can we categorize them in two category? So there are multiple ways we can find the line here. So it will categorize these 3 points alone and these 3 points in the other way. There could be this, which will categorize in different way. But what she has done, she has applied some logic and found that a function fx is equal to 1 by 1 plus e to the power minus 2x plus 9. If we apply, then we will get a curve like this. So this is actually called sigmoidal curve. Whose maximum limit is 1, so that's why y equal to 1 is behaving as a asymptote here. Okay, this is behaves as a asymptote here. Now the first question is that find what logic to separate the points. So we have two information. One information is fx and other information is the x coordinate and y coordinate of the point A, and based on that label is G1, and similarly for B, we need to find for the 4 other points. So how will we do? So part A we will solve like, let's find the logic. What is the logic? For logic thing, I'll take A, which is 1, 0.5. if I put x in fx, I'll get fx is equal to 1 by 1 plus e to the power minus 2x plus 9, and if I take f of 1, it will come 1 by 1 plus e to the power minus 2x plus 9. Now x is equal to 1, so 2 into 1, it will become 1 by minus 2 plus 9, 7, 1 plus 1 by 7. If I calculate this, how will I calculate? We are habitual to use now Desmos, so we will use that directly. So let's see. So the value is 1 divided by 1 plus e to the power 7, and we get the value 0.009. so fx value is 0.009. so here f of 1 is 0.009. what is the value f y here is 0.5. what does it mean? It means y is greater than f of 1. So point is above the line, and if the point is above the line, they has categorized as g1. This will be clear once we get B is below the line. So we need to check the B also. For B, the coordinates are 5, 0.5. So 5, 0.5. So f of 5 will be 1 by 1 plus e to the power minus 2 into 5, 10, and plus 1 e to the power minus 1. Similarly, again we will use Desmos for the calculation. So this will be 1 and divided by 1 plus e to the power minus 1, and we are getting 0.7311. So around 0.731, which is greater than y. If greater than y means the point which is B is lower here. This is actually, this value is, suppose this is a B point, then I'll say this is 5 and this point is 0.5 and we are getting fx is 0.7. So it should be up above the point. Yeah, it is above the point. So B is lower the line. B is the lower to the line, curve. So if B is lower to the curve, it is categorized as G2. Okay. So same thing we will follow up and we will see the results if the y coordinate of the point is greater than the function value, which is fx, will the point will be above the line and curve, and if the point is above the curve, it will be categorized as G1. And if the case other, that is if y is less than the f value, it means it is below the curve, and if the point is below to the curve, it will be labeled as G2. So we will calculate for all the points like this and categorize. So the using Desmos, a table is created and find out the fx values using x coordinate, and it is compared with the y. So for A, we have seen here that y is greater than f, so it was labeled as G1. B, we saw that y is less than f, f is the f value at that particular x, so it was labeled as G2. Similarly, you will follow the same procedure for others. So here f value is 0.27, which is greater than 0.2, it means y is less than f. If y is less than f, will it go in G1 or G2? We can see that B point showed the property, if y is less than f, then it will go in G2. So G2, similarly G1, G1 and G2.